Dr. Marianne, I've heard so many different views about co-sleeping versus a baby sleeping in his or her own crib. What is your opinion?
There really are a lot of opinions, but the first thing to say is that there's no one right answer. Some parents will want to have their infant sleep in the same room for many more months and will embrace the concept of the family bed. Others may want to begin to have their infant sleep independently. But as long as a family is committed to one approach, there should not be any problem either way.
So let's talk about co-sleeping. Some parents do it, others hide it, as if it's something for which they're going to be criticized for. Can you share with us your thoughts?
Well, you know, that's true. A lot of parents are made to feel guilty if they have their infant sleep with them in bed. Now, the American Academy of Pediatrics recommends that a baby not sleep in the parent's bed because of concerns about sudden infant death syndrome. However, a baby can sleep right next to the bed or in a cradle that attaches to the parent's bed. For many parents, this really helps with breastfeeding during the night, and it cuts down on their fatigue.
But what if you want to teach your baby to sleep in a crib or in a separate room?
Well, you can start this at this age by allowing your baby to fall asleep while drowsy. I think the biggest mistake parents make if they want their children to sleep independently right now is that they rock them or they feed them until they're asleep. And then when the baby wakes up in the middle of the night, they have to repeat this pattern.
Now, can you let a baby cry at this stage when they're falling asleep?
Well, I'm not a fan of crying it out at 3 months of age. You can let a baby fuss for a few minutes, and often they will settle themselves to sleep by sucking on a finger or a pacifier or rocking. But I would wait until 6 months before you can look into all the various recommended and safe sleep techniques. It's just too young right now.
How about swings? What are your thoughts?
Well, they're great for some short-term amusement and to give parents a break. You know, babies love motion, and today's automatic swings are even better than when my daughter was little and you had to wind them up. They also work really well to calm a colicky baby, but I don't recommend them for a regular sleep arrangement.
Thank you, Dr. Marianne.